Now, in this video, we are going to focus more on animal anatomy, or more specifically, bear anatomy. Now, of course, the image that you see in front of you is a human skeletal system and muscle system. So if you are used to having a background in life drawing or life sketching, where you do draw live models and you have a basic understanding of human anatomy, then understanding animal anatomy won't be that different, which is very cool. They're almost, you know, we have the same bones. They may not be in the same place, or some may be bigger than others, depending on the animal. But when you actually go ahead and look in there, a lot of the things are the same. You know, if we quickly take a look at the bone structure, right? We have ribs, just like other animals have ribs. We have a skull. We have eye sockets. We have a pelvic bone. We have a we have shoulders. We have bony hand. You know, we have these very intricate hands. We have a femur. We have the tibia. And you know, if you look at bear anatomy as well, they're pretty much the same. And, you know, if we take a look at our muscle skeletal system together, all these folds and overlapping shapes that you see, you will also see that in our animal anatomy as well. Like I said, they won't be the exact same. They'll be probably in a different place, and some may be bigger than others. But the essence is the same. The construction is the same. Now, every character and concept artist should study anatomy, because without a knowledge of anatomy, your drawings will really lack that credibility. And I know that sketching animals can be very difficult given the incredible variation that is there in the animal kingdom, you know, from bears to cat to horse. But always remember that there's a commonality between them and between us. You know, once these basic structures are understood, they can easily be extended to, you know, creating your own imaginary creatures. And once you have this knowledge of anatomy, you can almost create your own animals, which is very exciting, and which is kind of the basis of what we're doing, to be able to take all this knowledge and create something out of our minds, out of our heads, and, you know, maybe create animals that we normally wouldn't see otherwise in real life. Take a look in front of you. We have an entire skeletal system for the bear. We have a, you know, skeleton on the left, we have the muscle structure on the right, and we actually have the finished drawing in the bottom of the bear. Now, as you can see, you know, this is a very simple sketched drawing of the bear, but the artists that created this, they've added in the skeletal structure to understand the different parts of the bear, to understand where his weight is being distributed. Now, if you kind of take a look at, you know, this plan that we have in front of us, right, and it's this drawing of a bear, and inside that we can kind of see its internal organs. This process is, in drawing, it's called écorché. I hope I'm pronouncing that right. But this is the French word for flayed. Now, flaying or flayed has a very dark meaning, a very dark history. The literal meaning of écorché is to peel the skin off a corpse or carcass, which is, you know, it's very morbid. But in this case, we won't be doing that. Instead, you know, as you can see in the sample here, we'll be using this artist has used their reference images to imitate the process of écorché, or for flaying. So if you have, you know, a good reference image, you can actually very easily understand the anatomy that lies underneath it. Now, of course, if you know, take a look at the skeletons that I'm showing you, notice that it, again, is very similar, right? There's a lot of commonalities toward the human skeletal structure that I showed you earlier. Ribs, skull, femur, tibia, there's so many bones that have the same names as the human form does. So that commonality is very helpful. It'll really help you kind of grasp animal sketching a lot faster if you have that foundation for human life sketching as well. Now, if you look at the images that you have in front of you, I have the basic muscle system, skeletal system for a cat, but I've also shown it for a lion as well. This is also to show you that there are so many similarities between a lion and a cat, but also just a few differences. But it's very much the same structure again. So, of course, if you do want to draw a cat, sometimes drawing a lion could be helpful. It could aid you in drawing your cat sketches. But remember, a lion would have a much longer snout, a much bigger torso, etc. Whereas a cat would be much smaller in frame as well. And it's very complicated, I understand. Learning anatomy isn't something that happens overnight. It's something that I'm still studying, that I'm still learning. And the more knowledge I seek, the more lo knowledge that I learn and soak in, the better my drawings are getting. Don't expect yourself to get good at this overnight. I'm explaining this anatomy to you to help you understand that this is something that has to be a part of your sketches, that has to be a part of your drawings, and it's something that will evolve and get better over time. And you will see that in your work. So as you're drawing, as you're sketching, just remember to study as well. Study this anatomy, understand this anatomy. It'll make much more sense to your drawings, and it will make them more believable. And by knowing this anatomy, by knowing how to do these sketches, you will be able to create animals from your own imagination. You won't even think twice about it. You would have been able to just automatically learn how to do this on your own without overthinking it, right? Or without stressing over it. So have this foundation. Having a solid anatomy and foundation when it comes to your sketches is very important, and I do definitely recommend it. Now, these are two books that have been in my art library and are still there today. I constantly reference these two books whenever I do any kind of animal drawing or sketching. The first one is an Atlas of Animal Anatomy for Artists specifically, and that is by W. Ellenberger. And then the other one, which is a standard, like this book is my Bible, it is the Weatherly Guide to Drawing Animals by Joe Weatherly. So if you are deciding to do any kind of animals in your next project, I recommend going and getting these books right away. They are available on Amazon, and they will be incredibly crucial to help you become a better artist when it comes to animal sketching. And I live by these books. I've even personally met Joe Weatherly myself, and when you are around people like that, you understand how they become such good artists. And it's that constant repetition of drawing these animals over and over again that really help them solidify, their artistic strengths and make them the amazing artists that they are. Now, in the next video, we're going to take all the knowledge that we have learned in from the first video and this video, and we're going to apply it into our actual drawings. So we're going to use our photo references, or we're going to use our basic knowledge of anatomy and understanding of our characters, of our animals that we've selected, and we're going to start sketching. I'm going to show you the basic process for sketching, and eventually we're going to kind of focus on creating something from our imagination using the photo reference that we've selected.